Hi, I'm Ceng from Department of Neurobiology, 4th Military Medical University of China. I'm a group leader in pen study of our department, and we are mainly focusing on understanding the mechanism of chronic neuropathic pain. I'm going to share with you our new study just published in JCI. I'm the corresponding author for this study. Patients with neuropathic pain often experience exaggerated pain and psychiatric disorders such as anxiety, depression, etc. Both of these processes often interact with each other and enter a vicious cycle, rendering neuropathic pain more resistant to classical treatment. Therefore, exploiting a new and effective treatment for comorbidity of psychiatric disorders in neuropathic pain remains a major challenge. Cellular plasticity in the anterior cingulate cortex, ACC, is assumed as critical interface for pain perception and emotion. However, substantial efforts so far are focused on intracellular mechanism of plasticity rather than extracellular alterations that might trigger and facilitate intracellular changes. The extracellular matrix, called ECM, is not only a supporting scaffold but also a unique class of first messengers acting on the adherent receptors to modulate cell function in response to environmental changes. Therefore, we are interested to know whether the ECM plasticity occurs in ACC upon nerve injury and which extracellular-intracellular interacting processes are involved in the neuropathic pain and comorbid psychiatric disorders.
Hi, I'm Zhen-Zhen, the first author of this study. According to the above background, we carried out the following experimental design. Spinal nerve injury model was established in mice by dissection of tibial and peroneal nerves with the cerebral nerve intact. RNA sequencing was followed by behavioral testing, synaptic plasticity recording, molecular mechanism analysis, as well as pharmacological intervention. RNA sequencing in ACC detected 565 differentially expressed genes after SNI, many of them enriched in ECM receptor interaction pathway. Of particular, in ECM-related pathway, LAMBETA1 displayed a significant transcriptional downregulation. This was further verified at mRNA and proton level.
To address whether there is a causal relationship of activity-dependent changes of NAMBETA1 with neuropathic pain and anxiodepression, we first knocked down NAMBETA1 in ACC and assessed the behavior phenotype in knockdown mice. Here we can see that knockdown of NAMBETA1 in ACC induced significant pain hypersensitivity as well as anxiety and depression-like behaviors. This indicates that cingulate NAMBETA1 exerts a negative regulation of neuropathic pain and its related anxiodepression.
Then, how does ACC LAMBETA1 modulate neuropathic pain and anxiodepression? We next analyzed the effects of LAMBETA1 on the structural and functional plasticity in ACC. First, gouging standing method showed that knockdown of LAMBETA1 caused an increase in the density and a decrease in the length of total apical spans of ACC pyramidal neurons. Detailed analysis of different types of spans revealed that the density of stubby and mushroom-shaped apical spans were increased by LAMBETA1 knockdown. These results indicate that disruption of LAMBETA1 induces abnormal span remodeling.
Second, we assessed the functional consequences of NAMBETA1 deficiency on cingulate synaptic transmission by using whole cell patch camp recording. As we can see here, knockdown of NAMBETA1 in ACC increased the neuronal excitability and potentiates synaptic transmission of pyramidal neurons. Both the frequency and amplitude of miniature EPSC were increased after loss of NAMBETA1 in ACC. This suggests that NAMBETA1 deficiency potentiates synaptic transmission via both pre- and post-synaptic mechanisms.
Then by which mechanism does ACC LAMBETA1 regulate span remodeling? By using immunoprecipitation assay and Western blood analysis, we found that spine remodeling elicited by lambda 1 loss in ACC may be caused by a sac-dependent activation of the ROE, ROCK, Laminin signaling cascade, and hence abnormal decreased levels of active covalin, eventually resulting in rearrangement of actin.
Given the importance of actin stability in AMPA receptor membrane trafficking, we further found the enhancement of AMPA receptor and NMD receptor membrane trafficking after knockdown of NAMBETA1. GCAM6-based fiber photometry recording showed that NAMBETA1 knockdown leads to increased activity of ACC pyramidal neurons during tail suspension. This data indicates that pain hypersensitivity and depression induced by NAMBETA1 knockdown in ACC is associated with increased ACC neuronal activity.
Finally, we asked whether ACC NAMBETA1 possesses therapeutic effect on the neuropathic pain and aversive emotion. Since the NAMBETA1 gene is too large to be packaged in AAV for overexpression, we tend to seek for the usage of the agonist of integrin beta-1. Delivery of peri-integrin, an agonist of integrin beta-1 in ACC, reversed SNI-induced pain hypersensitivity and anxious depression, as well as F-actin dysregulation.
In conclusion, our present study leads us to propose a working model as shown here. Peripheral nerve injury leads to downregulation of NAMBETA1 in ACC. This reduced interaction with integrin beta-1 brings about decreased phosphorylation of SARC, which causes reduced ROE-specific GTPase activating protein, thereby increasing the level of GTP-ROE. Elevated ROE level activates ROCK2 and subsequently NAMEKINASE2, which phosphorylates covalin and deactivates covalin activity. This results in rearrangement of actin cytoskeleton, which further leads to an increase in presynaptic transmitter release probability, as well as abnormal postsynaptic spine remodeling and AMPA receptor synaptic trafficking, and hence potentiates synaptic function. The resultant structural and functional plasticity collectively contribute to exaggerated pain response and related anxious depression. In summary, this study primarily clarifies how NAMBETA1, a key element of ECM, conveys extracellular alterations to intracellular structural and functional plasticity, and modulates neuropathic pain and associated anxious depression. Furthermore, we identify peri-integrin as a potential therapeutic candidate for treatment of neuropathic pain and anxious depression. Future directions related to the aberrant remodeling of ECM might govern an important direction for chronic pain and related aversion.